Hello guys, Kudus here, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play World of Warcraft Leveling Legacy. We joined Dreamstrider here back in Bloodhoof Village. In the last episode, we killed some harpies, we found some grim totem scavengers that was up to no good, and then we went over to the neighborhood and defeated some Venture Co. goblin cartel people up there next to the caves. And now we're going to deliver the quests back in Bloodhoof and see what lies to relax on our journey here. The Grim Totem, Mull scowls. I'd hope to see the end of my days before Tauren attacked other Tauren senselessly on the very plains of Mulgore. But be proud, Dreamstrider. You have done a great thing for the land and for our people. There is more work to be done. We must create a new totem to cleanse the Thunderhorn well. You must gather the claws of the predators of the Mulgore Plains, hunt prairie stalkers for their stalker claws, and flatland cougars for their cougar claws, then return to me. You'll find the prairie stalkers and flatland cougars to the east and west. More hunting, yay! So some of these quests might seem kind of dull to begin with, to be fair. They involve mostly hunting. Hunting and killing, not that creative to be honest, at least not yet. The Wind Furies are deadly foes, their strength in battle is only rivaled by their desire for fresh meat. Oh, so they're carnivores. You've done well, Dreamstrider, you seem well prepared to travel onward, let the wind always be at your back.
Be careful.
That is a common saying among the Tauren. May the winds be at your back. So we have two quests we can do now. We can hunt for the cougar claws, or we can go and take care of those earth elementals, because there were some dwarves excavating in the area. There are some couple of quests more here though that we have to get, because the Bloodhoof Village is so large they didn't even pop up on my quest log previously. Greetings. This guy will probably send us to Thunderbluff, a bundle of hides. I have a bundle of hides from the animals of Mulgore, and I must get them to Thunderbluff. A colleague there, Hanu, will use the hides to create leather goods. Will you take the hides to him from me? The quickest way to Thunderbluff is on the back of a Windrider. Bring the bundle of hides to talk our Windrider master in Bloodhoof Village, and speak to him about transport to Thunderbluff.
We shall meet again.
That sounds like a good idea, so we should probably do that. Maybe we should do it right now. Take a look at Thunderbluff, because it's a fantastic city. You can see the Zeppelin there, up there and on the sky. It kind of just left from Thunderbluff, transporting between Orgrimmar and the city here.
The winds.
My grandfather told me stories about his battles with a strider named Mazranache. He told me of its demonic red eyes, razor-sharp talons, and venomous bite. As fortune would have it, while traveling across the plains, I encountered it, and it took a nasty bite from my shoulder. He was as terrible as my grandfather described. I have gathered all the parts of my remedy I need to cure myself, except a flatland cougar, femur. I grow weaker by the moment. Please help me. Go. Poor guy. Luckily, though, we are on our way to hunt for some cougars, so let's kill two birds with one stone, and then we can get on with it. So here you can see the mount vendors for the Tauren. You can buy the Kodos here. These are unarmored, and these have this plating on them. Kind of cool. I do love those mounts. One of my favorite old vanilla mounts.
Well met.
So this guy will take us to Thunderbluff. Are you here for the Windrider? Yes, I am. It's kind of strange that these guys, if you must take the hides to Thunderbluff, then you must come to the right place. Let's go with this guy for a small fee. Yeah, we know how this goes. If you're taking those hides to Ahanu, then I think he's at Hewa's Armory at the base of the Windrider Tower in Thunderbluff. That's right where you land, so that's really nice. Let's go and fly over there. I find it really strange, though, that these guys are using the same wind riders as the orcs. How can this guy actually carry a Tauren? I guess it must be a really big wyvern for that to work. I mean, in real life, horses have like carrying capacity for humans as well. So if you are a very heavy person, you are unable to ride horses. Or at least horses will be damaged if you let heavy people ride them over time. So, I guess this is a really big, strong wyvern, possibly. The Kodos, of course, are really strong and fit the Tauren really well. So here we see the main totem pole in Thunderbluff. We have a couple of districts here and some other mesas surrounding the city with specialized tents. They focus on different aspects of... Oh my god, look at this guy! I love the design of this guy here. Brave Tuho. Look at this guy! He has these amazing maces. I want to be him. Oh my god. Well met. We can buy the tabard. We really don't have to do that right now. But here you can see, this is like the main district. Some crafters down there. And here we have... Let's take a look at the map, guys. So we have the Elder Rise over here on the east side. We have the Spirit Rise, northwest. There's the Druid place, I think. Well, the Elder Rise used to be... Well, the Spirit Rise is the place where there are some spirit caves underneath. And you can go there to get visions and stuff. The Hunter's Rise is to the south with the warriors and hunter trainers. And then we have the Elder Rise here. I think this is for the shaman, this is for the druids, and this is for hunter and warrior. And then we have different districts here with different vendors and craftsmen. And of course, the totem pole in the middle is where we have the Wind Rider. So this place actually reminds me a lot of Banjo-Kazooie for some reason, a game made by Rare for the Nintendo 64. I'm not sure why. I guess it's the totem in the middle there. Something just resonates that with me. But here we see Bane Bloodhoof, the High Chieftain of the Tauren. You can see he has some totem poles on his back, and those are carried by the leader of the tribe.
Honor the Earth Mother, always.
Greetings, young one, and welcome to Thunder Bluff. Oh, he keeps talking. What is he?
I am Bane, son of Cairn, now chief of the Bloodhoof Tauren.
Yes. Greetings, young one, and welcome to Thunder Bluff. You'll find safe refuge from the burdens of the world here. All denizens of the Horde are welcome here. So this guy is really friendly. And one of the more nicer chieftains, or I think his leaders, faction leaders, for the Horde. The Tauren in general are really the nice people. They're all about the peace and being nice to each other and killing when it needs to, only they are really strong and they don't abuse that strength like the orcs sometimes do. Here we are. Here we have Hewa and Ahanu.
Looking for something soon.
There is a dust on your shoulder that must be from Mulgore. You have spoken with my friend Varg. Ah, a new bundle of hides. I will get to work on these immediately. Thank you, brother. You have done me a great service. Here are some coins to pay you, pay for your time and travel costs. Thank you. I have prepared leather goods for Varg to sell at the Bloodhoof Village. Will you bring them to him? Yes, I will. If you have already been to Bloodhoof Village and spoken to their Windrider Master, you can fly from Thunderbluff. Yes, let's go up there and do that. We have the auction house here to the right. We have a guy on the flying mount up there. And then the guardians walking around here. So I'm going to do as I usually do with these flight quests. We should probably... I could use the Hearthstone and get us back to Bloodhoof after I've delivered the quest to this guy. Sometimes I always use the Hearthstone just at this moment, but then I forget that this guy is actually the quest where I have to turn in the quest. Greetings, Druid, yes. You will need to take this to Bloodhoof Village, eh? No problem, okay. Let's go and fly with him back. I want to save my Hearthstone. I'm going to cut to when we are back there, even though it's not a far ride. So now we are back here in Bloodhoof Village, and let's go and deliver those hides. Man, always those flight quests are that they are the most dull part of the starting areas, but I guess there are a good way to teach people about the flight points. Dreamstrider, you are back from Thunder Bluff. Did you deliver the hides to Ahanu? Yes, I did. Ahanu sent me finished products. Very good. There are many hunters and adventurers in Bloodhoof Village now, and business is lively. I am sure I'll sell these goods very soon. Thanks for all your efforts, Dreamstrider. I am in your debt. Unfortunately, though, his inventory doesn't change if you do these quests. He will keep the battered armor here. And this is really, really terrible armor, so we don't want to interfere with that. We have new boots, though. We should probably put that on. We have gotten some meat as well. The good thing about these starting quests is that they are a really nice foundation if you want to start cooking.
Because we are fighting these, because we are fighting animals, they drop things like eggs, they drop things like stringy wolf meat, and of course strider meat as well, which are all parts of different recipes that we can cook. So yay, we can make food. Let's make our way over to this guy. I remember this quest here is a classic one. This guy's talking to this totem. What is he doing? Ahab Wituf, the old rancher. He apparently has a, he's not talking to the totem. He has a wanted poster right there.
Greetings, traveler.
Listen to his voice.
Go in peace. Greetings, traveler.
Help, Dream Strider. My prized puppy Kyle has run away. I just know he's running around Bloodhoof Village, lost and hungry. Will you find him and feed him? Once he eats, he will settle down and come home. To feed him, you will need to find food. His favorite meal is a tender is tender strider meat. Just venture east and you should find plenty of striders. Hunt one down and take its succulent meat to Kyle. When you see Kyle in town, put the meat down and he is sure to come to you.
I think this is actually a kind of a gift to well, not a gift, but I think the story of this quest NPC is kind of a sad one. I believe Blizzard gave the opportunity to a kid to voice the character and actually give the quest here. I can't really remember the storyline, but if you want to learn more about that, then Google, Google his name. And Google the quest Kyle's Gone Missing. So yeah, we need to find the cougar meat. We need to find flatland cougar femur. And we also gotta get those... get the strider meat. I guess we do have strider meat. I thought we had some... Yeah, we have strider meat here. How do we feed him, though? Feed Kyle. Oh, okay, so we got to find Kyle and then give him the meat. Okay, that should be a problem. Kyle is like a wolf running around the city. So let's make our way over here. I think we can actually make quite a lot of money of those eggs here. Yeah, it's 27 gold. They or these meat here is going for 29 gold as well. So yeah, food is actually selling for quite a bit if you're low leveled. Copper sells for a lot as well in Peace Bloom because people want to level their professions, of course. Can't forget to kill the stalkers as well. We need the claws. So let's kill all of these. Because all you need to do when you are a balanced druid, protector of nature, you want to kill a lot of stuff. I tend to find that leveling as a feral druid is a lot quicker. But the purpose of this series here is to level quickly. It is level, I guess, lore more slowly. It isn't to level as slowly as possible. That's not my intention at all. But to explore the classes to their extent. So I think I'm going to stay and level as a balanced druid because we will be able to become a moonkin. Well, or we could use a glyph to make us appear like we are some sort of astral being. So that's kind of nice. But yeah, moonkin. We'll get more into those eventually. But I'm going to stick with balance as it is right now because I haven't really played a lot of balanced druid, to be honest. I have always leveled as a feral druid. Because the ability to switch between going in melee using either energy or rage, and then going back out to heal while still conserving your mana and making the mana regen when you are in your fighting form is really nice to keep you going, especially back in the day when you had to eat, you had to depend on limited amounts of, well, you didn't have a lot of regen, I guess, for your abilities, for your resources, neither health nor mana. Okay, so we have a couple of quests we can turn in now. I'm going to cut to when we were back in Bloodhoof. Okay, guys, so I just realized that, Kyle, the wolf, he's kind of a stringy bastard because he's not content with eating strider meat. He has to have tender strider meat. Kyle would delight in taking a bite of this succulent treat. So yeah, he's a spoiled little wolfie, isn't he? But there he is. Speaking of the sun, I marked him. Made sure I marked him with my with a raid marker by right-clicking on the portrait and clicking on a target. So we got to follow this guy and cut him off and give him some food. I think we can't really give him anything unless we are closer to him. So let's make our way. I think he will run up here to the right now. No, he's taking the left. Okay, so we need to cut this guy off. This quest is really annoying. And it's been like this since the dawn of man. Well, the dawn of Tauren, I guess. You could find if you know which route he's taking, you can just stay there. But I am not content with that. Come on, come here. There we go. Eat your food. Yay. He's a happy wolf. Let's remove the mark now. And he starts to dance with us. Thanks you with a special dance.
Praise the sun.
We also have another quest we can turn in, and then we'll head up and deliver the Kyle quest.
Dream Strider, do you have the claws I sent you to gather? The Thunderhorn Waterwell grows more tainted with each passing hour. Thank you, Dream Strider. The purity with which these beasts hunt is vital in the creation of the next cleansing totem. The Thunderhorn Well is a symbol of my own tribe, and to know it is being desecrated by our own kind raises a fury in me I haven't felt for years. The Grim Totem are a tribe that believe all of Kalimdor should belong to the Tauren alone. That's their purpose. Their hate and anger led to a corrupting thirst for power. Magatha, their leader, poisoned our high chieftain Cairn Bloodhoof and attempted to take Thunderbluff for herself. But she was defeated and the Grim Totem exiled. Now they seek to ruin Mulgore itself as they are driven out. Quickly, Dreamstrider, you must go to the Thunderhorn Waterwell in the north and perform the ritual.
We shall meet again.
We shall meet again, indeed. So we are going to head up north here. Where is it? The Thunderhorn Well?
I guess it is further up here. There it is. Right in the middle and right in front of my face. Of course it is, right there. But we have a couple of more quests to deliver first, and we also have the dwarves.
My fever grows worse, and I find my mind drifting into delirious nightmares. I should have known that I wouldn't be able to handle a beast my grandfather was unable to defeat. Do you have the ingredients for the remedy? I fear if I do not clean the infection soon, it will be the death of me. Ah, thank you, Dreamstrider. Using the items you brought me, I will be able to create the remedy I need to stop the spread of the infection and eventually cure it completely. I owe you my life in thanks. But I'll never forget that screeching call when Matsranache came upon me. The blaze of color as its beak descended. Be wary on your travels.
You brace us. Thank you. Do we have anything else to wear right now? I think we have a... Nope, doesn't look like... Oh, a new cloak there, I guess. Not too big of an upgrade, though, but I guess it's better than nothing. So now let's get this quest to Kyle, and then we'll head up to the north, to the Thunderhorn, and to the Restless Earth Spirits.
Greetings, traveler.
Fantastic work, Dreamstrider. Kyle came home as soon as he ate and went straight to bed. Thank you for your help.
The winds guide.
The old rancher. Fantastic. And there we see the zeppelin again. I love this little water here. It's so beautiful. And the mesas and the... Wow. Even though I kind of dislike the quests here, to be honest, I find them to be, well, what makes this the hardest is the fact that these quests over here, they're kind of separated by the water, which makes you have to run, the fact that you have to run around this kind of creates for bad level design as you have to, it basically just extends the time you have to keep you, or this extends the time you keep running, so it will just artificially increase the playtime, which is not good. Simply by putting this obstacle in the middle of your face to hinder you. But yeah, more of these Grim Totem Defilers here. As you can see, they are like indicated by the fact that they are dark. If you can tell that they are evil, they are also they have black fur, and they have this face paint as well, I believe. Yeah, they have, I think, or maybe that's just their texture. I remember some horrible memories of the Grim Totem over in Stone Talon Peaks. Stone Talon Peaks is the area here to the north of Mulgore. And some of the Grim Totem live there. And they used to be a pain in my rear. They were so annoying. Oh my god. Oh. But we are going to keep on moving. That's the excavation point up there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut to when we are closer up there, because I don't want to keep running through all of these distant plains with nothing to do. Now we approach this dig site here, the Bale Dun dig site, or the Baildun dig site. We have some of these spirits here. I guess we can play the drums to soothe them, and they'll be friendly. So that's how you do it. You can see here, though, that some of these dwarves here have fallen. Some of them will starve. I guess this is the guy who has killed them, perhaps. No, the earth spirits, of course. They agitated the earth spirits, and the spirits killed them. That's pretty logical, right? So that's why the dwarves here are dead. You can see the banner of Ironforge up there. So these guys were probably part of the League of Explorers, sent out, led by the dwarf known as Bronborn's Beard, to investigate and dig up old artifacts. Oh, the spirit is displeased and attacks. Not good. Yeah, okay, so I guess we have to kill them if they don't relax. Take it easy, Mon. The music here, it kind of has the same drums as the back on Echo Isles, the starting area for the trolls. Check out that episode, the first one with the trolls. Episode 20, I believe, of Leveling Legacy. And you will hear this drum sound once more. Let's use the Hearthstone now, since we are significantly far away from our Bloodhoof. Good time to use the Hearthstone. I love the fact that the beard and his hair, the braids, they flow in the air when he's casting. It's so beautiful. So yeah, okay, Armo, we have dealt with the earth spirits. Well,
the land is clearly still in great upheaval if it took such effort to reclaim. To calm, I mean. Remember this, Dreamstrider. Do not forget seeing the fate of those who would scar the Earth Mother.
Be careful.
So the Earth Mother is vengeful. Why do we get so many bracers?
You've done a great honor for both me and my ancestors today. Please take this with my gratitude. I cannot thank you enough for cleansing my tribe's well, Dreamstrider, and for fighting the savage Grim Totem to do it. But there is more to be done, and it is time for your journey to lead you beyond Bloodhoof Village. Zalaman Two Moons stands by the fire in the north end of the village. Go speak with him and learn of the next ritual you must undertake.
Go in peace.
So yeah, that's one thing I haven't noticed before. So this is the Winterhoof well, this is the Thunderhorn well, and there is one more well up here, if you can see it barely up there. We also have a little area up here north here. So we will probably head up there now before we go out into another zone. We are almost level 9. Usually we will be about level 12, 10 to 12, when we are done with the starting areas, of course, as we've experienced with especially with the Gilneans.
Well,
I sensed you would be coming to me, Druid. I can always recognize one who is trying to pass the rites of the Earth Mother.
We shall meet.
Again, be sure you are ready to leave Bloodhoof Village behind, Dreamstrider. The next step on your journey will take you far from here. Your path continues to lead onward across the fields of Mulgore, the eyes of the Earth Mother on you at all times. When you are ready, consume the waters near the tribal fire. Once you have ingested the holy waters, your eyes will be opened, and the spirits will guide you. This sounds like some trippy shit we are going to go through here. Well, I'm going to save that until the next episode. Sorry if this one was a bit short, but I want to spread the content of Mulgore out into to equal episodes. So if I didn't cut the episode off here, then we would have an extremely short last episode. So yeah, see you guys in the next one. Make sure to like the video if you did enjoy it, and share it with your friends if you think they will enjoy it as well. See you guys next time, and farewell.
from Dreamstrider here. Bye-bye.
Hey, bye-bye.
Let's do the dance. Oh, looks like he's having a great time. Oh my god, he's so happy.